Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I make videos on crochet, art, vlogs, and lots of other stuff, but in this video, I am so excited to share with you guys the biggest, cutest, and best plushie I've ever crocheted, and it's the Catbus from Totoro. In this video, I'll be showing you how I made him and my process as a plushie designer. If that interests you, don't forget to like this video, consider subscribing, and comment down below your favorite Studio Ghibli movie. For those of you who crochet and would like to make the Catbus yourself, I'll be coming out with a pattern very soon, so make sure to follow me on Instagram at mochibimakes so you know when it's released. I'll be needing pattern testers too, so make sure to keep an eye out. Now, let's get on to the video. This plushie was commissioned by a wonderful client and I've had so much fun making it for them. I love Studio Ghibli so much, so when I got commissioned the Catbus, I was very excited. In the process of making plushies, when a client commissions any character for me to crochet, the first thing I do is try to figure out what supplies I should use, starting with yarn. Lately, the yarn I keep going back to for all my plushies is Parfait Chunky from Premier Yarns. You can really use any yarn you'd like, but just keep in mind your hook size and yarn will determine the size and texture of your plushie. I love Parfait Chunky because it is squishy, soft, and super affordable and really good quality. It's not too bulky and allows me to get a good amount of detail into the design. This yarn comes out to about 450 a skein and it comes in so many colors. Every project that I've worked on with this yarn, I'm always able to find a color for it and it's usually in stock, so highly recommend. If you plan to make this along with the pattern, and just for information purposes, here's every color that I used for the Catbus and how many skeins I needed of each color. In the very beginning of making plushies, the first thing I do is sketch out just to figure out what shapes I need to make. In the case of the Catbus, because it has a cubical and almost rectangular form, you have to create panels. Here's a diagram of how I created it and what pieces I broke it up into. These are, of course, are only the main big pieces. It doesn't include the ears or the windows, but these are all the main crochet parts. I started out with some applique work on the eyes and cut out all the felt pieces I would be needing. Then I sewed on teeth on the mouth, attached the mouth to the face, and all the rest of the pieces.
I'm working on the ear, and what I'm going to be doing is I made a base for the ear, and then I also made the inner part with felt. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay this on here, and I cut it out so that it's just tall enough for the ear, so that when you fold it, it looks like the pink part of what you would see of a cat. So right there, like that. But what I need to do is I need to sew this on to this part first, and then because this is the right ear, it's going to curve over for kind of that perspective of having like the skin over on that side. This ear is going to have the skin a little bit over here, but the other ear is going to have the skin a little bit over there. It won't fully make sense until you see it, but yeah, I'm going to finish up the ears. After sewing that down, I also sewed down this edge just for the perspective of the ear being the shape it is and where it is going to be on the face. So now all I have to do is crochet along this first line to put the two ends and the two sides of the ears together, like that. So I finished the base of the head, like most of the stuff. It just needs the ears and then it's done, which I'm so thankful for. I spent so much time on this. Yeah, I attached some whiskers. It looks a little bit funky right now, obviously, because it doesn't have ears. But I also did some darts along the head just so that the fabric laid a little bit better. It looks weird. Once it's stuffed, it'll look a lot better. But Yeah, I finished it up finally. It took so long. The hardest part, I would say, was the eyes. That took forever. And it almost killed me. But yeah, the teeth look great. I'm very, very proud of it so far. I hope the client likes it. This is such a fun plushie to work on. If you don't know, I also made Appa from Avatar The Last Airbender. Please check out that video if you haven't seen it. It's my most popular video. So I also want to thank you guys for that. It's over 2,000 views, I think. So thank you guys so much for your support on that video. It took so long and I'm so glad you guys like it. I work on these for a really long amount of time and I also work on them on and off. I just make things until they work, and then once they work and they're all done, it's hurrah. They're definitely not, it's not a straight line type of process. There's a lot of ups and downs. But yeah, I'm going to attach the ears. I'm thinking about just sewing them on with black thread, because it's a lot stronger than yarn. You can break them like this. So if you can see, you can snap them usually, see? Because I want this plushie to be very durable. I'm gonna just sew on the ears with this. So I'll show you guys when that is done. I'm going to send a photo to the client. I always do this as I'm working through the process. I always send progress photos. If you ever order from me, I always send progress reports so that you can see what's going on, if there's anything you want changed, and just so that it's just the way you like it, obviously. So yeah, I am very proud of it. I love it a lot and I am very excited to continue working on it.
So those of you making this plushie yourself, here is a little bit of a diagram of all the felt pieces that were needed to make the Catbus's face. Now let's move on to the body. This process worked up a lot quicker than I expected because I really, really went at it for a few days. I literally was just crocheting. That's all I was doing. It was really fun. But yeah, let's start with the side panels. I did not make them on camera, so they were already pre-made. They're almost like these trapezoid shapes that also have the stripe. All in on a little secret, but I actually made both of my side panels a little bit of the wrong size because I have two blue crochet hooks and I switched them up, and one is a 5mm hook and the other is a 5.5. So don't be like me, don't make that mistake. They're a little bit off, but everything else is all made with the same hook, so it wasn't too big of a deal. You can still kind of tell though that both of the side panels are definitely different sizes, but I made it work.
So it has been a hot minute. I have not filmed for this video in a very long time. I got very, very busy. I had my finals week and it ate up a lot of my December, and I didn't get a lot of work done on it. But we are finishing up the Catbus this week. Today's the 28th and I am like halfway done basically with the Catbus. I showed you the progress on it. So we have the head, we have the two side panels, and I'm currently working on the middle panel, which is also going to be the back. So here's the right side, the left side, and then the head, and then there's the top panel that goes down and it covers up the back. So after I finish that, then I just have to do the front panel and then the belly, which is the bottom panel. The legs, I'm thinking about releasing this pattern maybe in February. I've been on kind of a hiatus because I've just been so busy and just taking a little break for myself because it's been a hard few months, but 2022 is coming to an end and I feel like I got a lot of good work done this year, and I'm so excited for 2023. And I have a lot of good stuff coming for you guys. So I know y'all were yip-yapping at me about the Appa pattern, and I still don't know if I'll even be able to release it because I'm still missing parts of it. So I only have little bits and pieces of it. But this one I've written down enough that I'll probably be able to string together a pattern, and I will need testers. So if you want to test that pattern, or if you even want to just see that pattern, please check out my Instagram. We're gonna finish up this middle panel and then I'll get back to you once it's done.
I just chained the width that I wanted the top and back of the Catbus. I made sure that it was a good size for the head, crocheted along that, and then did a little bit of increasing to make the back, single crocheted the rest of that, and then that is the top and back panel. I eventually switched to the mustard color again so that the whole back panel wasn't just chocolate brown colored. I also had to make sure that it was lining up with the stripes. I forgot to record the part of the process where I attached the windows to the Catbus, so they're going to be included in the pattern, of course, but they're just some things that I totally forgot to film during this video. I believe there are 6 windows on each side, so it was not an easy process, and I did it quite late at night, so it's fine. You're not missing anything, I promise. Then I worked on the final last panel, which was the belly. I also did the front panel off camera, so it's very similar to the back panel. It just doesn't have the top part, I guess.
Finishing it up today. I got all the panels done except for the bottom panel. So we have the front panel, which is right here where the head will be. We have the top panel, which it goes on top and then wraps to the back. And then we have both sides. And then we obviously have the head. So after this, I need to make the belly bottom panel, and then I will move on to making the legs and the tail, and then I'll do applique and like detail work, like windows, and like I want to take a minute to thank my client who commissioned this for me, It has been such a joy to work on this, and I'm loving how it's turning out, and I'm so happy that I get to make this for you. I'm so appreciative for every order I get, and I thank you for your patience. Sometimes it just takes me a little bit longer on some projects than others. Thank you so much for your patience, and I'm so excited to finish this up for you. It's gonna be a really great plushie. Yeah, I'm so excited. It's looking really cute. I've kind of calculated it out, and I should have enough for each, so I have the bottom panel, which is going to be the cream colored, so this is for the belly, and then I kind of mark out what skeins are for what, so if you work on big projects that might be helpful if that's something you struggle with. So I'm going to get to work on the belly, and then I'll get back to you guys when I'm working on the legs, the tail, and the other details.
But yeah, I worked up the belly. It was super easygoing. It didn't take too long. I just sat myself down, and the entire belly panel is just made out of cream yarn because I was going to attach the legs onto the top, so you weren't going to see where they connect anyway, and it just looked really seamless and wasn't too difficult. So definitely an easygoing time. I had Minecraft going on in the back, so I just got to calm down and just chill before we had to make all 10 of the legs. So yeah.
It's so cool. Oh my god.
I didn't record much of this part, but the parts that I did record, I got, and it was only one clip. But basically, I single crocheted together all of the panels at the edges that they were meant to connect to with the brown yarn. It came out super clean, and I was literally in shock because I was in shock because I was just so excited, and I was very happy with the progress. And then the next morning, I started working on the legs.
I'm just in a really great mood. This is January 1st of 2023. I'm just ready. I have more of the legs done. I think I just have a few more to do. Then I can finally go outside, get the photos and video that I need for this video, and then make the post, and then ship out the Catbus. The client that I've been working with on this project is so sweet, and I love them so much, and I'm gonna be so happy once they can receive it. I have almost everything I need to get a pattern out for this. Testing will probably take a whole month, which is probably gonna be this month. I've seen so many requests on my Oppa video for the pattern of that. And if I can go back to my phone and try to figure out something, then I definitely will. That video is now at, I think, 5,000 views, which is insane. That's my highest viewed video, and that's crazy. I'm so happy that you guys like it because I loved making that video, and I hope this one gets at least this, like, similar attention. It's also a very big plushie. I'll show you guys how big it is. So this is the Catbus. It is massive. Like, it's probably around the same size as Oppa. I will measure it. I don't think I measured how big Oppa was, but this one is big. Like, it's super big. I stuffed this very quickly. Usually big plushies are very hard for me to stuff, but this one surprisingly went down really easily. I'm gonna start working on the legs.
If you are a rapid, or I don't know what the word is, if you're a huge Studio Ghibli fan, you know that the Catbus actually has 12 legs, not 10. I ran out of space, and also just to make the pattern a little bit more comfortable and less tedious, I just took out a row. Also, your girl was playing yarn chicken for the last portion because I was scared I was going to run out of yarn. So I decided to go with 10 instead of 12 because trust me, all the detailing on the feet, you're not going to want to do it 12 times. But if you somehow want to fit 12 on yours, definitely go ahead. I would just not recommend it. I also made a super chunky tail in off camera. It literally is just an increase in the magic circle round, and then I did a little bit of striping and then ended with the mustard color where it connects to the body. The next part is all applique work and then assembly. So I cut out all these stripes for every single foot on the Catbus and a paw pad for each. Here is a diagram for all the felt pieces needed for the legs and the felt piece that was used on the front panel, which is just a little red headlight. I sewed these on by hand with thread just so that they were super secure, and then I also added claws or nails with cream colored yarn threaded onto each foot. I did 3 on each. Then off camera, I finished up all of the appliques for the Catbus. I did all of the stripe, the paw pads, and the claws. I also did the claws while they were unstuffed, that way I could hide all the knots. And then I sewed on the paw pads, then I attached all the legs onto the body so that he would look like he's in a sitting position. And then the Catbus was all done.
Guys, I did a thing.
It is late on January 2nd and I finished the Catbus. I outdid Appa, I think, with this one. That was my biggest plushie. This one, it takes the cake. For a size comparison, I am 5'6½", so I am about 167 centimeters tall. This is how big it is compared to me. I'm not very, very tall, but I'm not short, okay? It's so big, it's so huge and chunky and soft. And like squishable. It's like there's no hard parts in this. I didn't put any boards to structure it. It's like, it's gonna be hard to take a thumbnail photo for this because it's just so huge. Basically, I live in California and it's been raining insanely. Like it's literally been flooding.
The relentless line of storms, that parade of cyclones.
Quadruple its normal rainfall.
So I am gonna try to take photos hopefully soon.
Okay, so the last thing that we did was take photos at the park. We took the Catbus there. The weather finally cleared up. It was raining for days and days on end, and it was flooding everywhere. But my sister took really nice photos for me, and thank you for that because I really, really love them. This project was so, so fun to work on, and as a kid who grew up kind of on Studio Ghibli, it was really fun and creative, and I got to make something that I really liked, and I also got to make something for somebody that's really special, and I love it so much. You're gonna see me do a lot of Lion King, and if you've seen Avatar and Ateum, because, you know, it's just, yeah, we love Avatar. But I feel like this plushie allowed me to stretch my creative mind. But the pattern will be out very, very soon. The pattern test post will be up on my Instagram within the day or the day after this video is posted. So if you guys want to test, I would love to have you. Thank you guys so, so much for watching this video. And until next time, bye. Oh my God. So I'm sorry for that.
So here's the front side, the back,
because.
Thank you guys for watching this video. It was so, you're probably not gonna be able to hear it.
I have to come towards this tree.
Huh?
Say come here.
Oh.